First I would like to thank the organizer for the kind invitation to invite me to participate with you here and give you a little brief about the e-government initiative in Saudi Arabia. The time I have is just only around 10 minutes, so I'll go very quick through some of the main achievements and direction of the e-government in Saudi Arabia. First of all, let me give you a little bit brief about the e-government program in Saudi Arabia. It started in 2005 in a participation between Ministry of Communication and Ministry of Finance and the CITC, the regulator of ICT. The concept of the e-government program in Saudi Arabia, it's been said to be coordinated decentralized approach and unified vision with action plan and a shared infrastructure among all the different government agencies and with common standards and practices across government agencies. The hierarchy or structure of the program, it has a supreme supervisory committee with the Minister of Finance as a member and the Minister of Communication, Information and Technology and the Governor for CITC. And also there is a steering committee headed by the Governor of CITC and a representative from the three ministries. I don't know if there is a laser pointer here. No. Okay. If you can see, we engage the government agencies through e-government committee, each government agencies headed by the head of the government agencies and coordinate with the e-government program. And there is a dedicated program who coordinate, plays the coordination facilitation between the different government agencies. We just finished our first action plan, our first five-year action plan, 2006-2010, and this year we started our second action plan. I'll give you a highlight about the main components and the main focus of the next 5 years of the Saudi e-government. The vision is enabling everyone to use effective government services in a secure, integrated, and easy way through multiple electric channels. So this is the Saudi Arabia vision out of the e-government. We'll try to achieve out of the e-government. This is for the second action plan. The main components of the second e-government action plan, as you can see in the middle, there is a different tracks. This time we are focusing more on the human capital and in the field of communication, information technology, and change management, because we thought that's the main things need to be improved in Saudi Arabia to, in order to make sure that the e-government initiatives are sustainable. So a big focus on the human capital and also on the institutional framework to refine and strengthen the institutional framework. And there are a lot of other tracks which has different initiatives, for example, the infrastructure track and the e-service track and the national national shared systems. And a new theme or a new track has been introduced to the second action plan, which is the e-participation based on the best practice of the United Nations. So those are the main work streams of the second action plan. And the themes the initiative goes around is around sustainable workforce and public improving the public experiences of government services, collaboration and innovation on the government agencies, and increasing the government efficiencies. So those are the main components of the second action plan. This is the strategy map of the second action plan, the different objectives that take us to the vision with the balance scorecard perspectives. So I will not go in details of this, but this is the way how it's mapping to each other to take us to the vision of the second action plan. That's a little brief about the second action plan and the component. The second item I would like to talk about is the governance of e-government in Saudi Arabia. There are a lot of regulation has been put in place by the Council of Ministers to give the e-government and e-transaction the enough regulation that supported. For example, the IT Criminal Act and e-transaction Act and the rules governing the private sector participation in e-government implementation and also e-government implementation rules. All of those regulation has been issued in the last 3-4 years, which supported a lot the transformation to e-government. From the e-government infrastructure projects and achievements, we have the Saudi e-government portal has been launched 5 years ago, and it has a lot of information and services for the government agency services, more than 700 e-services already available through the national e-government portal by around 100 government agencies providing those services, and around 450 acts and bylaws also available on the portal, plus so many other areas, you know, and services, information and forms, and also a lot of e-participation features like blogs and public consultations and customer feedback about the services and evaluation, and also a lot of open data and Excel format from the different sector and different perspective. So a lot of services and information on the national e-government portal. The improvement is continuous. A lot of improvement from the United Nations themes. The best practice has been identified by the United Nations, also try to implement it in the portal, and that goes as a model to the rest of the government agencies. And we see government agencies improving their portals whenever they see a new feature on the national portal. Also, the e-government program has established an e-government data center to play the role of connecting and coordinating the traffic between the different government agencies, and also a government secure network to link the headquarters of the government agencies. We have in Saudi Arabia more than around 340 independent government agencies, and those independent government agencies, they have a lot of branches under them, so the government agency is responsible of connecting their branches, and we in the e-government program, we are responsible of connecting the headquarters together through this government secure network, IBVB and MBLS network provided by the telecom operator in Saudi Arabia. There is a more logical layer on top of the data center and the e-government security, which we call it the middleware or the government service bus. We have built a government service bus which orchestrates and, you know, organize the traffic and the services, shared services between the government agencies. There is a provider domain here and a consumer domain here, and there is a bus in the middle, where a consumer can call the bus to bring in a service or a data from the profiler. A real-time transaction can go through this logical layer. A lot of e-channels also linked to the middleware, and a lot of channels have been provided to the customer to come through. So the customer comes through the unified channel or the government uses channel to request or to apply for a service. Then the government agency who are providing the service can request the data about the consumer through multiple government agencies. Today, providers is we have more than 10 government agencies providing data and service to the rest of the government. For example, Ministry of Interior, citizen data and expat data, and Ministry of Commerce, the commercial registration data, and so on and so forth.
The also part of the infrastructure has been put in place to support the e-government implementation. Saudi is a national center for digital certificate, which is the PKI, has been established and operating now and starting to issue certificate, PKI certificate, to the rest of the government agencies in order for them to use them to improve the security of the e-transaction. Even though the penetration is still very low, but now the center is operational and start to give certificate. Also, we have implemented a single sign-on services, which allow the users with the government agencies to register in any one of those 40 offices available for them. They register online and they go to one of those 40 agencies to prove themselves once. Then after that, they have a credential to be used with other government agencies who are using them. There are 102 employees in those offices, and now there are more than 25,000 establishments and companies has registered and the single sign-on. This service now are available for enterprises and for individual will be available very soon. Those are the offices which help enterprises to register and authenticate and activate their accounts. E-channels, in Saudi Arabia we have plans to activate and open all channels for customers to reach government issues. Most of the channels now has been activated. Some work now is going on the contact center and kiosks to make them, and public service centers to make them available very soon for customers to come through them to government agencies.